Hello. In this video, we will learn about models, which is a key capability of BMC Helix Continuous Optimization. To manage the ongoing demands of your business, do you have business critical questions, like, can I satisfy new business driver requirements, like increased page visits, for the next 6 months? Which is the best target server to deploy my application? How do I ensure I have the resources to successfully deliver my upcoming projects, and so on? If yes, then models can help you with the answers. So, what's a model? Model represents a simplified mathematical description of a set of resources that can be used to evaluate historical data, predict future behavior, and simulate scenarios. After creating a model, we can define various scenarios that help to clarify how the given predictions might change with changes in the system or business driver data, and arrive at the solution that best corresponds to our needs. With models, you can easily manage the ongoing demands of your business by predicting the infrastructure needs, estimating whether the existing resources are adequate to meet the current and future demands, and planning accordingly for the new infrastructure. In BMC Helix Continuous Optimization, we have time forecasting models, queuing network models, and extrapolation models. Now, let's learn about each type of model. Time forecasting model. This model predicts the future behavior of one or more performance metrics by considering their past behavior captured over time. For example, based on the internet usage between July and September 2021, we can predict the trend for October 2021. To create any model, we need model inputs to get the model outputs. The inputs for a time forecasting model include the performance data for system or business driver metrics, a backward time frame for a period that we want to observe, as well as a forward forecasting time frame that we want to anticipate, a forecasting algorithm that we need to apply to the data, and a fixed or dynamic threshold. So, the output we get from this model are predicted resource utilization and business driver behavior, calculated by the applied algorithm, and the estimated date when the threshold will be breached. Now let's learn about queuing network model. We can use this model to predict future system utilization, throughput, queue length, and response time based on the impact of changes to the business drivers running on the systems. This model is built from a performance versus load analysis considering CPU, memory, and disk resources. To find the appropriate configuration that meets the working business scenario, we first need to create a baseline, that is, set business drivers' goals in performance versus load analysis and set thresholds. Then we simulate business drivers' growth and what-if changes, like hardware or system configuration changes, to evaluate capacity levels. We can keep running the prediction until we find the appropriate configuration. Now let's learn about extrapolation model. This model estimates metric values in relation with other metrics based on the correlation defined in the correlation analysis. The inputs for an extrapolation model include any one type of the correlation analyzes, a forecasting algorithm that we need to apply to the data, and a fixed or dynamic threshold. The output that we get from this model are estimated residual capacity, estimated value of a particular metric when another one changes, and we can also identify when the potential threshold is breached. That brings us to the end of our video. To know more about models, visit the BMC Helix Continuous Optimization documentation. Thank you for watching.